Great sentence, Abigail. Can we? I'm trying to make it mostly straight. Unlike me. Boom. I make that joke every time. It has not gotten funnier in the last 9 years. And I'm not sorry. Excuse me. Anyway. Yeah, it's been kind of stormy. Anyway, yeah, I'm back, and I thought that we could maybe do some fun stuff if we layered the effect of the wind and the trees against the effect of, some microphone brushing. So I have a bunch of different things here, mostly brushes. Something more stable and secure, so you wouldn't have to deal with this sound nightmare. I'm sorry. But I have all these brushes. This is a small sampling of the number of brushes that I actually own for painting. I'm not like a real artist. You know, whatever that means. I mean, I'm a real artist in that I make art and I enjoy doing it, but I'm not like renowned or very good at it or whatever. I just kind of do it for fun, and I think that there's a real joy in that, that if more people discovered, maybe we would live in a better world. You know, the idea of it, I don't know, it took me a long time. I'm still sort of trying to learn that art is not just about accomplishment. I mean, this applies to life too, that like life and the human experience and the artistic experience, that they're not just about like recognition from external parties. Like I mean this is not like revelatory news for anybody, I don't think, or at least for not for many people, but I'm still in the process of learning, and it has really changed my life to sort of begin to realize that like it's okay to make art just because you want to, even if it's not good. Like making bad art is one of the biggest joys of my life. And you know, I say that like genuinely believing that a lot of my art is actually really good. Again, not that it belongs in a museum or anything, but just that I like it and I'm proud of it and I enjoy looking at it, and the people that I make it for like it too. So anyway, yeah, I don't know. The reason I have so many different fucking paintbrushes is because I took a painting class in college with a relatively prolific painter as a professor, and she was just a shitty teacher. Like, she's a great artist, made like really incredible, thought-provoking stuff. I was excited to take her class, and then I showed up, and over the course of the semester, it just became really clear that like knowing how to paint and knowing how to teach painting are really different things. Really different things. You know, especially when I think about some of the other sort of academic art experiences that I had in college. That was one of the more disappointing ones, and I think it was because it felt prescriptive in a way that a lot of my other courses felt more free. You know, even if they were about technique, it was about applying that technique to what you wanted to be doing. I don't know, I'm kind of just rambling. I'm gonna start brushing. Let's start with this big one. Used to be white and brushes are universal. You can use them for any kind of paint, but I'm willing to bet that what happened here is I used oil paint on an acrylic brush, and now it's stained, but I kind of like the color of it now. This is how the influencers do it. I'm too white for this. You can't tell. Oh well. Also, my camera's not that great, but what are you gonna do? Anyway, I just thought we could sit here and talk a little bit and enjoy this. Oh, yeah. I really like the way that sounds. Oh, baby. Up to and including the beginning of 2020. Like, it's weird, I think. If you asked me when I was 8 or 10 or 15 or whatever, what I thought my 25th year was gonna be like, I think there's a weird sort of dichotomy there that's creating some cognitive dissonance for me. Because there's the half that's like, oh, the world is like falling apart, you know? The world's like low-key ending. I mean, not quite yet, but I was reading the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists the other day, and I didn't realize that even before all of this coronavirus bullshit, they had moved their doomsday clock closer to midnight than it has ever been before in the last 75 years since the invention of nuclear weapons. So yeah, I mean, we're not doing great as a species, and that's concerning. So there's that one part of it where I think if you talk to little me, whatever that means, she'd be terrified. But then also turned on. Like, I mean, not to be vulgar, but I think quite a bit about how if my 14 or 15 year old self met my 25 year old self, I mean, she'd fall in love, like, irrevocably, instantaneously, and not even in a cute way, just a, like, mild obsession. I don't know any other gay people because I'm 14 and I live in Kentucky, you know, like, I mean, I had a lot of those crushes, not a lot, but a good number, and it does sort of tickle me to think that if I met myself, you know, the one version of me would be starstruck and the other version of me would be nonplussed. I mean, that's kind of my ideal character development or character progression or whatever, you know. Oh, this is so good. I'm really enjoying it. It's doing exactly what I wanted it to do. I mean, why not, you know? Let's move on. Let's do something different. Because I do have this brush that is really more for, like, wall painting. I mean, it sounds great just on its own. Yeah, but I bet that it'll have a different sort of effect on this microphone. Oh yeah. Oh shit. looks fun. My camera's not that great. But you can sort of see the way the bristles want to shape against the microphone. Yeah, they're dancing. One of my favorite activities, to dance. Oh, this one's nice. Interesting to think about, because I really admire people who can do realism in any form, in any medium, you know, or whether it's paint or metal sculpture or, I mean, whatever, you know, anybody who can do realistic renderings of things, whether those things are in their mind or in the real world, it's kind of incredible to me, because I am not good at it. I find it tedious. Some of the best classes I took in college were art classes, and one in particular, I took basic drawing, which was a lot harder than it sounds based on the name, just in terms of the amount of time that I had to put in. But it was cool because I really learned more than anything else. I learned a lot of technique, but through the process of learning that technique, I learned that art is, like, at least to some degree, like an acquirable skill. It's something that you can learn, you know, it's something that you can learn quantifiably. You can sort of, there's a mathematics to it, which is really fascinating, and which I had never really considered. I think I had thought of art as sort of a thing that you either have some innate talent with or you don't. And it's not like that. I mean, these aren't new revelations for anybody, but it was fun to learn them in my own life, you know. And I think there's so much value to just creating for the sake of creating without much respect to, you know, whether it will be externally validated, whether it will make me money, you know, whether it's any good, you know. Like, I think the process of making art is so joyful and so meditative and so, I mean, I could go on about this for a long time, but it's taken me a long time to sort of learn that it's okay process of creation, even if you wind up with nothing at the end. So, you know, in that vein, I've become more and more willing to embrace my tendencies to dive into abstract art or even just meaningless art, you know, stuff that I do just because I think it's fun, rather than trying to make things that are beautifully photorealistic, which, you know, well, it'll just never be a skill of mine, and that's okay. I actually have, I mean, I have a couple of my paintings right here. Let's see. maybe 3 and 6 hours every day to get this to a place where it looks like sort of like a room, you know? I mean, I really love it. It's probably the most, it's probably the best realistic painting that I've ever made. Of course, it doesn't hold a candle to some of the stuff that, you know, my friends are regularly able to do. For example, I'm just seeing this one. This is a self-portrait of a different person. My friend gifted this to me years ago, and it's a self-portrait of him. And, I mean, I'm never gonna be able to make anything like this. It's incredible. I mean, it's based off an actual photograph, you know, and he's, if you look closely, you can see it's actually a grid painting, and each square is painted individually, but I mean, it's just, like, I'm never day-to-day, I tend to gravitate a little bit more towards, gosh, I mean, we can just keep going. This can be a mic brushing and a painting expose video, but in real life, I tend to gravitate more towards, yeah, just towards abstraction, you know? I like self-portraiture, but I've never actually made a self-portrait that was realistic that I liked. I don't know if I've ever made one with a face that I liked. Painted in oils with fingerprinting from like a year and a half ago. I love this piece. I know, like, you know, it's the kind of thing where this isn't, it's not hard to do. And I think my threshold for like tolerating bullshit when it comes to like meticulously trying to make art, it's pretty low. I want things to be enjoyable and I mean, not necessarily easy, but enjoyable. This was just a cathartic, like, physical experience, you know? It was, I like it more than I thought it would, and I think it's because it felt good, like, from a physical perspective, just to make it. Oh, you hear the frame cracking. I stretched that canvas myself, I hope it's okay. Do we have anything else that's interesting? Let's look. Oh, here's one. I think it's beautiful. I think it's really cool. I'm happy to have it. I will eventually hang it, you know, somewhere, as I will the rest of these. Like, I'm really happy with how it came out, and it was a really fun, interesting study in, in realism, you know, but it's just ultimately not my thing. Like, the, you know, 15 or 20 hours of work time that I spent, you know, making this look good was not necessarily worth the emotional output that I got from it. I like having it now. I don't regret doing it, but it's not something that I would choose to do again outside of like an academic context. Oh, man. Oh. I didn't do this painting, but here's eventually make a video, although it's a little bit cliche, with no talking and just some microphone brushing, because it is content that I, in specific situations, really enjoy and appreciate and benefit from. What the fuck am I gonna title? gonna try to keep this video a little shorter than some of my previous ones have been. I think we're already around the 30-minute mark, so, you know. Maybe we'll try a couple of these ones that I liked one more time. Ooh, I like the metal sound of that. The wood is nice, but the metal is better. She's great.